On Hatteberg's People, sometimes out on the prairie as an outdoorsman and hunter, you have to make some unusual decisions. Well, Evan McAnally of Wichita certainly did, but more important, he recorded what happened on his phone, sharing that moment with the rest of us.
You're right, buddy. You're right. You're right.
Few hunters ever witness this. A 9-point buck with antlers entangled with another 9-point buck that has been eaten by coyotes.
He was fairly active. He was still pushing and dragging, and I mean he had a lot of life left in him, and I knew then that I probably should try to step in as much as I could to try to free him. I was just trying to calm the deer, petting him, scratching his neck a little bit, and it did seem to work. He really held a constant pressure against me. I had originally started to try to just manipulate the horns to get him to come apart, which didn't work at all. The connection that I really felt with him, it was more towards the fact that he allowed me to do what I did.
Evan has been a hunter since he was a child.
I was raised in a family that hunting is what we did, game is what we ate. You know, I hunt what I eat, and I eat what I hunt. It's not a sport, in my opinion. It's not fair to the animals to call it a sport. It's just a predator-prey relationship that's been going on forever.
But on that fateful day, the predator-prey relationship changed. Could he save the remaining entangled buck, or would he have to put her down? Well, Evan couldn't get the buck freed by hand from the carcass of the other animal, so he went back to his truck for a wood saw.
Because I knew it was going to be harder to cut through and take more time and more vibration, and I ended up just making it halfway through the horn and was able to snap it off, and at that point he really was free. At the last point, I actually had to reach down and slowly kind of raise his head up just so he could realize that he wasn't attached anymore. He saw the horizon and he just realized that I can go, and he moved on. I just had a sense of relief that it was over, obviously, and that he was able to get up and run off and hopefully, you know, survive. I would love to see him again as much as possible in the future, but I just couldn't reach for my bow to take him. I really think he could see me and recognize me as well as I could look at him and recognize him. He trusted me to do what I did.
I think all of us would love to know what that deer thought about what Evan did. I'm Laurie Hatteberg.